Where did you get some?
Yeah.
Did you get some? No, go get some.
You did it.
Okay, now go get your money. Go get your money. Yeah, there you go, buddy.
Good morning.
Bright and early good morning.
This is the face of jet lag.
This is a combination of like tired, but also sad that we left Fiji, but also exhausted because we had so much fun in Fiji.
We spent our last 2 weeks at two different places.
The first place was Jean-Michel Custeau Resort in Savu Savu. No, we're there. Come on, let's get off.
That was long.
Just for a second, people often email us and ask where is a good place to travel with your family, like my like top 10 or something. And this quickly made it quite high up on the list as best places to travel with your family. And here's why. The Bula Club.
Also known as the Kids Club.
It's their kids club. And each child under the age of 5 has their own nanny. What? We would have been happy with one. Or just like one for a bunch of kids.
Yeah.
And we had one per child.
We've stayed at a lot of places around the world, and we've worked with a lot of like nannies or sitters. Might be number one. Mm-hmm. Not no, sure, but it might be number one.
So while the kids are away,
the parents will play.
Oh. Are you pretending like you're not?
Whoa! That was cool.
Yeah, I guess?
Yeah, and your band came off? You ready for goggles?
Huh?
You ready for your goggles?
That's the part of the trick!
You weirdo.
So then we traveled from Savu Savu back to the main island. Island hopping has been super duper easy here in Fiji.
Wait, there's two things I need to point out. One is we've been working with Fiji Vacations, and one of the most stressful parts about traveling is those travel days. When you land somewhere and you're not quite sure, like, okay, where do I go from here? What do I do next? Fiji Vacations has been a dream because every time we land, there's somebody there waiting for us. Even the night before, actually, they call you and say, your flight is at this time, this person's gonna pick you up and take you to this place. So all that like potential stress, just
gone.
Second thing I need to point out is Manila loves planes. And when he sees a plane for his first time, it's like a challenge to me to make sure I've got a camera on his face when he first sees the plane, because his reaction is
epic! Place in Fiji was Nanuku Resort.
We arrived to Nanuku at night, which I actually really love arriving to places at night because you can only see so much and then you get to wake up the next morning and see everything. But at night we arrive and I was expecting a typical hotel or resort, but it wasn't. We pulled up to a house and it was like an actual house, which felt so nice, right?
So nice.
And it was beautiful.
Morning waking up in Nanuku was just amazing, seeing like how beautiful the place was. We walk over to breakfast, we sit down, we're eating breakfast, and then someone from the hotel staff comes over and says, oh, you guys have your shark dive today
in 4 minutes.
And I just wasn't ready for it.
Take some mental preparation to know you're gonna be in the water with sharks
and big sharks, like big,
you'll see
water.
Okay, so wait, okay, so let's set the stage. We are wearing regular scuba gear. But the guides, what are they wearing?
They're wearing, what is it called?
Chain link suits.
So shark armor.
Yeah. And then they have these metal canes. So we're like, so we're not gonna be in a cage. We're not in a cage for this dive. We're in regular scuba gear. But the instructors are in chain link shark protection suits with metal canes. Did they give you a cane?
And they tell us, they said, okay, there's a wall. Do not go over this wall. Don't put your hand. Don't put your GoPro out. If you have your GoPro, put it right here.
Don't extend your fingers.
And so I'm like, oh my gosh, like, what are we doing? And then I see these guys suiting up. And
which is just funny. You get a lot of like mixed signals when you're going on this dive because it's like, they're safe. They would never do anything. But don't extend your fingers.
But don't you.
But don't cross them. Oh, especially when he's like, and if a shark goes behind you, don't turn your back on it. It's actually a site where they're trying to rebuild the life, rebuild the reef and the coral,
yeah,
and everything.
Yeah, 10 years ago it didn't even exist. It was just an incredible site.
Jessica loved it.
I was in heaven. My fears and anxieties like quickly went away once I saw these like beautiful creatures. And we're sitting there and just enjoying it. And I mean, like, sharks are just totally misunderstood
creatures.
That's
what I told Jessica when she was feeling nervous. I was like, it'll be scary the first time you see one because you're like, you cool? I'm cool. Are you cool? But then as soon as it like comes and checks you out and then passes on, you realize, like, you get a feel for their nature and you realize they're beautiful, they're safe, and then you just admire, like, how wonderfully cool and amazing these creatures are. Wait, favorite moment of the
craziest dive. Moment.
It was intense. Is a shark is going after a piece of food and it starts, like, thrashing this piece of food, and it just happens to be next to the wall where Jessica is, and it knocks over these rocks. Like, a shark. These are big rocks. And it hits it, and it just, like, poof, knocks the wall.
Oh my gosh. I was so scared.
What was going through your
mind? I was, like, just enjoying it. I was like, oh, this is just so beautiful. And then you see a shark, you know, like, kind of frenzying, trying to eat this piece of food, and it's just like...
Then it got real.
Whew! My heart rate. Like,
so after that...
Sky high.
I don't know if I have this footage, but after that, Jessica reaches down and she found one of the guide's metal canes, and you see Jessica like... ready for that.
And then eventually the guide was like, I'll take that. You don't need that.
Who are you? When we went down, it was a beautiful sunny day. When we came back up, crazy rainstorm. And kind of spooky because the island that was, like, just right there is now gone. You can't see anything. You look in every direction and it's just crazy rain. And then it rained and it rained and it rained. And we got to see a side of Fiji that we hadn't seen so much because it rained and rained the rest of our time in Fiji.
We enjoyed it. We were like, it doesn't even matter. Let's go play in the rain. Pool? Yeah.
Since I came here, felt the joy and the fear, finding myself making every possible mistake. La 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 la
la
la
la la la. You gotta go under a little bit. Go under just a little bit. Go like this. And get it. Yeah!
One, two, three.
See, I'm a young soul in this very strange world, hoping I could learn a bit about what is true and fake. But while this hate tried to communicate, finding trust in love is not always easy.
Here, Dorothy, you hold this part. Okay. Oh, guys, look, Mom has ice cream.
Okay.
Go for it.
Fiji are the people. So they're so kind and they are just happy. Like, they're nice and they're happy people. They're happy with their lives in Fiji. And what did someone say? They said, come to Fiji and happiness will find you.
Oh.
That's so deep. It's true though.
A lot of our travels have been focused around trying to find what other cultures different than our own do to find happiness. And we found a lot of happiness in Fiji. Fiji, if you'll have us, love to be adopted into your family, into your culture, and forever be Fijian.
Nanuku Fiji, meno mutalenga, gotu masara, handaungan rewa, mainaya tuya sawa, kambuya watunaya tulau, Fiji men romaikea. Vindelana, Shuku Shukura, Windrokan Roka, Paravinduku Bula, Kaseka Bula, Viti Menromai Kea. This land is your land, this land is my land, from the California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest, a voice was calling, this land was made for you and me. As I was walking to the ribbon of highway, I saw above me that the endless highway, made for you and me. And this land was made for you and me.
A big, big thank you to Fiji Vacations. Anyone watching this, if you are going to come to Fiji, first thing you need to do is check out Fiji Vacations. If even just for good information, like they have so much information, so many connections. And now is the sad part when we leave Fiji. But the exciting part when you're a full-time traveling family and you've got somewhere cool to go. So next week, we hope you'll tune in. Stay tuned on Instagram. Please subscribe to our videos and we will see you next week. You gotta say hi.
Hi.
How old are you?
Five. Tell Daddy, what was your favorite part about Fiji?
Fishies.
The fishies?
Yeah.
You like the fishies.
Did you like the seaplane?
Yeah.
What's the seaplane say? Yeah. What was your favorite part about Fiji?
Snorkeling.
Oh, that was so much fun. You want to go get breakfast?
Yeah.